We're about to talk to Chief Fred Lamontagne in just a couple of minutes, but first of all, take a look at what's happening right now. They are knocking down the north wall of the Jordan building. They say because the fire is not out yet, and the building is condemned so that the firefighters are not allowed to go inside, so this is the only way they can shoot water into the building to continue to put out the fire, which again is still not out. Now, the fire chief is waiting for a news conference to begin right now. Chief, right now we're just talking about what's going on behind us with the knocking down of the wall. What is the situation? This building's condemned, so they can't get inside?
The challenge that we have here with this structure is the fact that the building was under demolition. Some of the structural supports have been modified, and that makes its stability in question. So we have to go to different tactics and different measures to gain access to the deep-seated fires that have occurred.
I understand that a fire of this magnitude has not happened in this part of the city in decades, this big of a fire?
That's correct. This the last fire, it's been almost 10 years since we've experienced a fire of this significance in this downtown district in Portland. This is a old commercial structure that has several series of renovations that have occurred over the last 10, 15 years, and it's really posing tactical problems to us as a fire department. The men and women of the Portland Fire Department have done a tremendous job. We received the call approximately 1:30 this afternoon for a fire inside the building. Upon arrival, we had heavy fire spreading throughout the window, throughout the building. The wind was spreading the fire faster than we could get crews in place. Second and third alarms were transmitted, bringing all of Portland's 42 on-duty firefighters to the scene, plus an additional 60 off-duty personnel responded as well. We've been supported by South Portland here at the scene, along with Cape Elizabeth, Westbrook, Falmouth, Cumberland, and Gorham has helped us manage the other emergencies that are going on in the city at this time.
What's going on right now with the backhoe right now?
The question is, what's going on with the backhoe behind us?
Behind us is the fact that we have the fire pretty much contained. The situation is very stable, but we have deep-seated fire inside the building itself. The building measures approximately 300 by 1,000 feet, so the fire has traveled the entire length of that structure. And so we've utilized the backhoe here on scene to break strategic holes inside the wall so we can get to the deep-seated fire and the collapsed part of the building. This is going to help us knock down the remaining fire and hopefully get the streets in this area of India Street back open again in the next several hours.
Chief, there was a lot of demolition going on inside.
There was a lot of demolition going on. He's asking, will these people be going inside?
We're very concerned about the structure itself. The structure has obviously been weakened by the fire, but also by the demolition that has been occurring. The owners of the structure, Peachy Construction, along with their demolition contractor, have been very cooperative. We've laid out a plan where the structural demolition that is occurring now is going to hopefully provide us the access so we will not have to put any firefighters inside the building, and we'll be doing everything from the outside.
And even though this building was under construction and there were people working here, as far as you know, everybody was out of the building. Nobody was around when the fire started.
That is correct. At the time the fire was started, everyone has been accounted for. There's been no injuries to civilian or firefighters on the scene, and we're very pleased with that.
Electricity is still out in this area.
Electricity is still out in this area. That is the question. They're asking when they might be able to get the electricity back on.
We've been working collaboratively with Central Maine Power there. They've been on scene since the beginning of the incident. Right now, we've minimized the area to pretty much India Street, down through Commercial Street over to Franklin Arterial. That 3-4 block area from Hampshire Street to the water is still without power and probably will be for the next couple of hours. But the areas that were originally without power, Munjoy Hill, it's all been restored, and we're pleased to see some restoration and normal services.
And how much longer is this going to go on as far as
the question is exactly how much longer this might take for the rest of the day?
At this point in time, I suspect it will be here probably close to the midnight hour, if not a little further. It really depends on how successful we are with these access points and what additional steps we need to take to reach the fire.
Thank you so much, Chief Fred Lamontagne.
Chief, thank you very much. Again, that was Chief Fred Lamontagne of the Portland Fire Department, one of many, many fire departments that were here. And also, along with the Portland Fire Department and the South Department, South Portland Fire Department, that was actually here fighting, fire crews from both Gorham and Cumberland were called in to man the firehouses that were empty because so many Portland firefighters were on the scene. But again, you heard the chief say that everybody is accounted for. So despite the magnitude of this fire down here, everybody seems to be okay. Nobody seemed to get hurt. So, Norm, Tracy, we'll send it back to you.